Produced by bacteria, Botox is one of the most poisonous substances in the world. If vaporized, one teaspoon could kill millions of people because it stops muscle contractions. How would it kill? Well, one example, if we inhaled it and it got into our diaphragm, a muscle, we'd no longer be able to breathe. Skeletal muscles need nerve impulses to do anything, so Botox works simply by blocking nerves from sending their messages to the muscle. Here, at the nerve terminal, where the nerve and the muscle meet, the nerve would normally transmit the signal from the brain across the gap called the synapse and into the muscle. However, Botox blocks the release of the nerve signaling molecules, called the neurotransmitters. This means that the muscle would never receive the signal from the brain and will never contract. But when used in very localized areas of the body and in controlled situations, we can use Botox to target specific nerves, going to the specific muscles that we wish to prevent from contracting. That's how Botox works. Here are five areas where we can use this effectively. In cosmetics, when our skin gets squashed together due to the underlying muscle contractions, the elastic nature of it can be weakened and lines can form across the skin. We can target muscles of the face to stop them from contracting at all, so preventing the skin from being moved in this way. If we can't, for example, raise our eyebrows, then we can't form these lines where the skin has been compressed, so it would never lose its elasticity or form areas of weakness. Yes, you'll lose the ability to make some expressions, but it will also prevent the formation of visible wrinkles. The second is overactive bladder. Having an overactive urinary bladder means that your bladder might contract at inconvenient times, sometimes causing pain and sometimes causing incontinence. Surgeons can inject the walls of the bladder with Botox, preventing the muscle from ever contracting, which is the cause of these symptoms. I'll note that the bladder is made of smooth muscle, which doesn't always need nerve impulses to contract, but overactive bladder happens to be brought on by nerve signals, and so Botox works effectively in this case. The third is muscle spasms. Some severe neck pain or other disorders can be brought on by muscle spasms. Botox can prevent these muscles from contracting and alleviate these disorders. Fourth is migraines. Some muscle spasms can even result in migraines, headaches, or other symptoms, and if the right muscles causing your issues can be targeted, Botox can potentially clear these up as well. The final use is excessive sweating. Nerve impulses result in sweat glands being stimulated to secrete sweat. Because Botox prevents nerves transmitting signals, if you inject this into the areas where your nerves meet the sweat glands, you'll prevent those glands from ever sweating. So Botox is dangerous in nature, but really useful in the right hands.